Hello, my name is Bjarke Petersen, and in this presentation I will go over the details, findings and results of a case study we have done on a science camp called RoboCamp 2019. The background for the camp was that we could see that there was a lack of workers within the field of STEM, namely engineers and candidates within natural sciences. Therefore, in the outreach initiative, the Panama Project, which is funded by the European Initiative Interreg, we decided to have two science camps as one of our outreach projects. This article revolves around the RoboCamp 2019. It was a 5-day long science camp and was held twice during the German autumn holiday. It was free of charge for the participants and it was aimed at 7th to 9th grade pupils. The objective of the camp was to motivate the participants to pursue a career within STEM. Throughout the camp, we used mixed methods to collect data. We had pre- and post-questionnaires, and we also used semi-structured interviews, observations, and conversations with the participants. The teaching and the learning at the camp. The first part was an introduction to robotics and the development platform. At this part, we took a more traditional approach to teaching and learning, and it was based on lectures on how to identify robots, their core components, and the interplay between these. It was also mixed up with physical activities, such as a physical activity trying to display the limitations of the interplay between the core components, and there was also an introduction to programming with the Arduino platform and the sensors and actuators that would be available at the camp. For each of these steps, there was hands-on exercises, and there were tasks with altering these setups. After this, there would be project work, and this was based on constructionism and problem and challenge-based learning, with a focus on having a low floor at high ceiling due to us not knowing the participants' previous experience within the field. The project was based on a coffee bean sorting and distribution central in order to anchor it in a relevant and actually real-life application context. Here, the participants would function as hired engineers, hired for the task of automating the bean sorting, which was color sorting on 3D colored pellets, and the distribution part, which was based on line following. For this, we had made a series list of materials. We had Lego manuals describing the basic models in case that some of them was not familiar with the Lego Technic platform. We had made 3D models for implementing the electronic compartments into the Lego modules. We made something that we called cheat sheets in order to limit the scope of where they could find the necessary information to work autonomously. We had cheat sheets on basic components, programming concepts, sensors and actuators. We had a 3 meter long floor mat depicting the central itself, where there was a loading zone and sorting area, and then they could drive around and deliver the beans in the warehouse. The materials will be made available at the link you can see in this slide, and it is also presented in the article. To accommodate for the low floor and high ceiling, we had made a list of proposed extensions for each project so that the skilled pupils could carry on and the not familiar pupils could focus on completing the basic requirements. Overall, the results showed that the participants had been really happy to attend and would like for there to be a camp next year. They had also kept their motivation, which was initially quite high, and a lot had attended similar initiatives before. They also fulfilled the learning goals, and a lot of them had made quite serious extensions, and quite a lot of them too. However, they felt that they had used less mass than expected, so probably we should highlight this in the future. We also found that there had been fewer female than male participants, so a different approach and/or materials could also be beneficial in the future. We have some recommendations. It should probably be held during a long holiday, since it is voluntarily. Also, the constructionism and PBL and CBL worked very well. And they were happy that it was physical objects and not abstract, and it was relevant to the industry and their future careers. The cheat sheet works as intended, and they were able to find the relevant information at themselves and work autonomously most of the time. At the end, we also had an exhibition, which let them take pride in their work and reflect on the learned, and this worked really well too. Thanks for listening.